Over the years, there are a number of companies that have claimed they'll be the first ones to build a usable flying car for the masses. For one reason or another, most have failed, others have stopped calling their products flying cars and went for VTOL vehicles, but none have actually put something useful in customers' hands. And now a Chinese company called XPENG AEROHT claims it will be the first one to mass-produce flying cars. Granted, there's a nuance to this statement, but there seems to be real progress in making it a reality. XPENG AEROHT was born back in 2013 in China with the goal of making flying cars. Since then, no less than 5 generations of such things have been made. All of them have been prototypes only, not actual products that can sell, but the work remains impressive nonetheless. The Chinese company presently focuses its efforts on designs called X1, X2, and T1. These vehicles, however, pale in comparison to something that was shown at the 2024 Consumer Electronics Show in January. A project that is known internally as the X3F, and commercially as the land aircraft carrier. On an official level, the contraption is described as the first modular flying car to be mass-produced for individuals, but that's actually a bit of a stretch. That's because if you consider a flying car something that you can drive on the road and then take up into the sky, the land aircraft carrier is anything but. Twisting things a bit, XPENG AEROHT slapped this description on a modular vehicle that basically pairs a good old van with a VTOL. That means you can drive the van to wherever you want, then climb inside the aircraft it carries in the back and take to the sky. The van itself will be all electric, all wheel drive. There are 6 wheels on the thing, with 1 axle front and 2 of them rear, and all but capable of carrying 5 people. The exact specs for the ground vehicle have not been disclosed, but some of them should make it under the spotlight soon, as its official unveiling is just around the corner. The thing has a very large space at the back where the VTOL is carried. That thing kind of looks like a small container equipped with 270-degree panoramic windows, landing legs, and 4 propellers. The aircraft is electric too, and uses a distributed electric propulsion system whose exact details were not unveiled either. The VTOL can be flown either under the control of a pilot, or in autonomous mode. XPENG AEROHT said back in July that its commitment to making the land aircraft carrier assembly will take the form of a production facility to be built in Guangzhou, China. Back then, I kind of took that announcement with a grain of salt, seeing all the previous failures of the companies that have tried to do such things before. But here are the Chinese proving me wrong by announcing they have started building that exact same facility. They're talking about a place spanning in its initial stage some 1.94 million square feet, and equipped with 4 major workshops, composites shop, joint shop, painting shop, assembly shop, accompanied by the required infrastructure. Because this is not a simple car the group plans to build there, the factory will use a traceability system meant to ensure compliance with aviation safety standards. The company describes the location as the first facility globally to apply advanced assembly line processes for large-scale flying car production, and it is where both the van and its accompanying VTOL are to be built. At first, the facility will be able to spit out 10,000 units per year. It's not clear when the Guangzhou assembly plant will be completed, but XPENG is already hard at work laying the groundwork for the success of its idea. After flying the VTOL for the first time in front of the public in September, the show debut of the carrier is expected to take place at the China Air Show on November 12. More importantly than that though, pre-sales of the modular vehicle are to begin by the end of the year. We don't have many details on how that's going to go, but it's likely that only the Chinese will be able to place orders for one at first. As far as how demanding flying the VTOL will be, XPENG claims the simple command and control structure of the thing, which basically relies on a single lever, should allow people to learn how to operate it in just 5 minutes, and get really good at it in just 3 hours. If that doesn't work, there is always the choice of going for an autonomous flight mode. The same autonomy capabilities are also what govern separation and reconnection with the van that carries the VTOL.